tiny ones with clay. But I will make. Let me know if you like.
We were young and we were free and running. Never bothered about what could be coming. Every day we danced and life was smiling. We were young and drunk in love. A few years later I have started thinking, if it's just love in every glass I'm drinking. We're like one and without you I'm sinking. I'm always shining next to you.
Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. This video is some sort of studio vlog. I haven't made these in quite a while, but I want to get back into it. This video is quite a long one, so grab a drink, grab your sketchbook and enjoy. And I'll speak to you guys in somewhere later in this video. Alright, hi. I thought I'd be doing some quick recording while I'm working on this palette. I haven't been doing a lot of ceramics in my YouTube videos
doing
lately.
My ceramics in batches.
And that is because I haven't been doing ceramics lately. Because of the prices, that the electricity prices that have gone up a lot. The rent of the kiln has become incredibly expensive. And for me, that means that I basically need to rent an entire kiln. That's the only way for me in order to be able to pay for the kiln. Because if I rent the entire piece, I only have to pay like half of, or even a third of the price that I would have to pay if I ordered only a part of the kiln. So yeah, it has been become impossible for me to only do small batch ceramics. So instead, I've been planning doing ceramics in bigger batches and planning them for multiple shop updates. So I'll rent an entire kiln. I'll try to fill it as much as I can, and I'll have ceramics for two or even three shop updates. So that's what I've been doing. I must say I don't really enjoy working in this way, where I basically have to do a lot of ceramics in a month. I prefer to do just smaller batches of ceramics, just make whatever I feel like and then have a small collection to show off. And yeah, I don't really like having to work in these huge amounts. It's also a hassle to bring the pieces, the unbaked pieces to the kiln, because I don't have a car and I have to do it by bike. So yeah, but since I'll be doing a lot of ceramics this month, you'll probably see me working with ceramics again. I'm planning to do at least a lot of all the designs that I really like. So I'm planning to do cloud palettes, I'm planning to do moon palettes, and I'll also be doing a lot of rectangular palettes that I'll be painting with leaf designs, and maybe I'll do some dog designs and just decorating them, which I'm looking very much forward to. I actually already have a lot of rectangular pallets finished for this. And I maybe also want to try and already prepare for my Christmas shop update, which will be in November probably, or even October. Because I've been wanting for years to do a luster. I think it's also called luster in English, which is basically like a liquid gold that you apply to a already finished ceramics piece, and then you bake the piece for a third time, where you basically bake the gold into the glaze, which is something that I've been wanting to do. And the lusters are quite expensive. They're like 60 euros for a tiny, tiny little bottle. So it's only for some sparkling things. I want to paint some stars. I want to make it nice and like wintry sky feeling. But I have the luster already in my house and I haven't used it yet. So that's a shame. I have to use it. But of course, like baking a third time with such an expensive materials is also going to up the prices of my ceramics again, which is something I'll have to figure out and see how I can make it work. But that's something I'm looking forward to doing this year. I've had that luster for almost 2 years now, and I just haven't found a time where I can like fill the entire kiln. And now, because of the high electricity prices, I have to fill an entire kiln anyways. So I might as well get ready to try out that luster thing that I've been wanting to work on. So yeah, that's been fun. I also made some sketches in my sketchbook to see if I want to make some more stylized, cute palettes. I made some sketches with like dog and cat palettes, and I made some to maybe make some cute brush holders, but I'm not sure if I want to make them, because I do really like the like stylish, elegant look of most of my palettes right now, and I like the simplicity of how to make them, and that it's not like, it's really relaxing to do, and it's not it doesn't require a lot of brain power. It doesn't have like a lot of things that can go wrong, and that's what I really like about how I make my ceramics right now. So yeah, I might or might not do those. If I am going to make them, I'm probably going to film a little bit, so you guys can see it too. Yeah, I do still really like ceramics. I think ceramics is a really nice way to take a break of illustration when illustration is not going well. It's really nice and relaxing to do. It just gives me some time to really think about what I want and make these beautiful products that people really seem to enjoy. And I get a lot of messages from people that say that like using my ceramics has been motivating them to paint, which is the most amazing thing ever to hear. I like, if I can inspire people to paint and making their painting journey a little bit more enjoyable, that's also what I wish to do with my YouTube videos. So if people say that my ceramics do that for them, then that's just amazing. But I do kind of feel like making ceramics for my webshop as my business, it's not really sustainable, because they're a lot of work and I want to keep them somewhat affordable. And I haven't really found a way to monetize them in any other way than just making them and selling them. Whereas if you look at my illustration, I can make a design for I can make a print out of one of my designs that I've made. And then I need to make the design once and I can sell the print many, many times. So that's something where I can do the work once and then earn money even years later. And of course with my ceramics, that's not really an option because I just make one palette and then it sells and then I have to make another palette. I guess I could make molds where I make a palette and then I make a mold and then I use like a liquid clay to then fill the molds and then I have the same palette over and over again without a lot of the work. But I know some ceramic artists who do that, and you know, the palettes they make are still beautiful, but I also like that the ones that I make now, they're all unique. So I'm not sure how I feel about that, so I don't know if I'm going to do that. If you've been watching my podcast, you might have seen the state of my workspace. This here used to be a big pile of boxes, which is now currently not here because I'm cleaning it out. As you can see, it's still a big mess, and I hope to try and get some change into that. Starting to show some process, I still have a lot of clay that I need to sort out. This is what I've already sorted out, and this is something I still need to look at. What I'm doing is I'm looking at the clay and seeing if it's the right hardness. I've had some clay that I've recycled that is soft enough to be wedged. So I'm wedging those, and I also have a lot of clay that's slightly too hard to work with. So I'm putting them in a wet towel and storing them in one of these crates. And then in a couple of days, it should be soft enough to wedge. So yeah, hopefully I'll be able to use all these hard clays again, and I won't just accumulate more slightly too hard clay. Because it's becoming a bit of a problem, it's taking a lot of space. Alright, we moved this closet from the living room to here, so I'd have some space for me to put my art supplies in, so I don't have to have them on my desk. My desk is still a bit of a mess, but I feel like we got pretty far today. Alright. Look at that. I finally have a desk again that I can use. I put Doggo's blankets back under my desk. And now I finally have a somewhat livable workspace again. And I can start doing some ceramics. Every day we danced and life was smiling. We were young and drunk in love. Yeah. Years later, I have started thinking if it's just love in every glass I'm drinking. We're like one, and without you, I'm sinking. I'm always shining next to you. Oh, I got you. There's no reason to chasing pavement on my own, 'cause you're here to stay every night. So yesterday I carved all the palettes that I've been that you've just seen me make, and I also made this little guy because I've been wanting to learn how to sculpt. Let me see if it focuses. I've been wanting to learn how to sculpt. So this was the first guy I made, and then today I made these five. which I think turned out pretty cute. I'm not sure what I'll do with these, if I want to if I want to sell them as sculptures or if I want to make them into tea pads, which would mean they would be unglazed. They would be baked once, but not glazed. But I'm not sure. I'm just enjoying it for now. Learning how to make better ceramics. And trying out new things. Maybe I'll use them to... maybe I'll make more of these little small... tiny ones, maybe even smaller than this one. This one is already quite small. Maybe even smaller and make them part of my ceramic palettes. I'm not sure. But this is what I've been doing today. And now I want to do some painting. So let's get into that. So I really like when artists do their art supply haul stuff in their vlogs, where they get some art supplies from the shop and they test it out and they see what kind of color combinations they can come up with. And I really like that and I want to include that in my videos. But I don't want to buy more art supplies. I have a lot of art supplies. I don't need any more art supplies. I probably will buy art supplies now and then, but I don't want to do it just for the video. So what I have come up with is, I already did this in my last video, so you can check that out if you like stuff like this. But I will make a color palette based on something, or I'll just figure out a color palette and then I'll grab some art supplies. Maybe some art supplies that I haven't used in a while, or art supplies that I really want to use, and I'll make a brand new color palette and then I can make art with that color palette. And today I actually want to generate a color palette. I just googled color palette generator. I would like to click and just go with that, but if it's a lot of greens I might click again, because I don't want to use a lot of greens today. Okay, it's fair to say that I re-roll this one, right? I'm not gonna... I just said I don't want a lot of greens. Alright, this seems more into my color palette taste. And I really like the dark green here, with like all these grayish and then the pinkish color. So I'm going to collect some art supplies and then I'm going to get back to you guys. Alright, I got my supplies ready. I had forgotten that I had got some new soft pastels to work with, and that I actually got like these nice neutral tints that work perfect for this color palette that I rolled. And yesterday I found back these like really cheap makeup sponges that I had used for ceramics, and they might actually be perfect to use for the soft pastels. I think we're just gonna do like some loose, very loose swatching. Let's get some brushes to see what we have, and if maybe I need to like take out some of the paints, because I did get quite a lot of paints. Right, we'll just do the swatches next to this page.
It's been a while since we talked, and my head's getting nervous. I can't handle this on and off. I can't know. I just gotta know where you are if I want to remain sane. But you're ghosting every text and call. Oh no, you could be running off with somebody else. Ooh, boy, I ask myself. Maybe you're just off doing what you said. Ooh.
Tell me what's the hold up, baby. Tell me why your phone's off lately. I don't wanna go all crazy, but I think I'm losing it. Tell me where your heart is these days. Are you being honest with me? I don't wanna go this cray cray, but I think I'm losing it, bad. I think I'm losing it. I think I'm losing it. I think I'm losing it, bad.
Let me know if you like this idea of the swatching with a simulated, generated color palette. Switched over to a new sketchbook while that other one is drying. This is actually a gessoed page, so it's going to act a little bit differently than the normal paper in the sketchbook. I'm going to be using this as reference. This is a cat, like how to treat cats. Book, how to take care of them. I found this in our local cat cafe and they were selling it for really cheap. And I looked through this. Like, this is incredible. Look at these, all these different cats, like the different furs and how they can look. And then they're showing like what it means, how they're acting and if they're playful, or like you have all these cats in these different positions and it's explaining you what it all means. So I thought that was just like really good reference, and then some anatomy and stuff. So yeah, I'm gonna be drawing from this one. And even is about like how kittens get born. And the different phases of how the cat goes through labor. So yeah, I thought this was a very, very good book and I'm gonna draw from it now. Let's see if we can, let's just open it up here. And we'll have this one is quite cute where he's eating, and here Harry's like washing himself after the meal. So let's start with that. And since this is the first thing I've drawn today, I think I want to time myself just for like, normally I do 2 minutes, but I want to use paint, so I need a little bit more time. So I think I'm gonna do 5 minutes. Can see the texture of this gesso is quite rough. So yeah, it's just a little bit different working on this patch, but that's okay. Don't really have a good color to show what he's eating, so guess it doesn't matter too much anyway. Alright, I'm gonna pause the timer for a second. I'm gonna leave this to dry. And then when it's all dry, I'm gonna draw on top and continue the timer. Because it just needs a little bit of time for me to work a little bit more easily on top of it. Alright, I don't like how it bleeds here. It's probably due to the gesso on this page that it just all works a little bit more difficult. I had pre-gessoed a couple of pages in here just to try it out, and I don't like it. And now I have these pages that are already gessoed and I still have to like make them work. But I think I'm almost done with the gesso pages, and then I can finally enjoy working in this sketchbook again. And this was a really quick one. I'm not too happy with how this turned out, but it's like the first thing I've painted today and on a difficult page. So yeah, I think I'm going to continue with this limited color palette for a little bit, and then when I am done with this sketchbook session, I'm going to show you guys what I made today and also what I've made over the last few weeks, just to tell you what I've been up to, what is going on in my mind, and what I'm working on right now. And I hope you'll like seeing that with me. And all right, I'm gonna see you when I get there. So let me show you guys what I've been working on for the last 2 weeks, I guess I'm going to show you. Let's start with the sketchbook session that you've seen me do in the last video, which is this one. I started with like what I've done before in this video, where I picked like a color palette and I gathered a bunch of art supplies to work within this color palette. And here I swatched all the colors that I got and just tried out like what kind of textures and techniques I could get. Then I started to do like these two-minute sketches. So I had this one and I had this one. And then when the 2 minutes were over, I just wanted to add like a little bit extra. So I said it's like a 2.5 minute sketch. And this was so much fun. I've been wanting to draw more chickens, and there are so many gorgeous chicken breeds. You'll definitely see me draw more chickens in the near future. But this was a lot of fun. So I did these two to start out with. Then I did these two, which took 4 minutes both. This one had more like an undersketch with like a pencil before I started painting. And here I started like more with the soft pastels and with the color first. And then I did some pencil lines on top, just some different approaches. And I think these are very cute. And then when I was warmed up, I wanted to try and do some preparation for a finished piece. So here I did some sketches, and here I did like one final sketch to test out the composition and test out the colors. And then I also worked on like a beautiful piece of watercolor paper to make a final piece. I don't have it with me right here, so if you want to see it, I suggest you check out the other video to see how it turned out. And I think this was a great sketchbook session and a great process for me. So I definitely think I'm going to do this more often, where I just do like a color palette, then some warm-up studies, then some sketches for a final piece, one final sketch, and then a final piece. That seems to work very, very structured and very well for me. Then at evening, I joined the Emma Carlisle Patreon session, actually. She had a sketchbook session where we were going to draw a lot of doves. I remember this was the first page that we drew, where you had like 10 minutes and you should draw as many doves as you could in 10 minutes as a warm-up. She had like one big picture with a lot of doves on it, and I think I got quite a lot of them done, and I think this looks pretty cool. Then this one I wasn't too happy with, but that's okay. It's not the best, but you know, when you're doing a big sketchbook session, it's not that bad if you have a couple of bad ones, because you'll be making so much. Then we did this one, which had a little nest, and I gave him like a hat and a scarf. I wanted to give like a lot of them hats and scarves. You saw it here too. These guys have hats. And then I did these. And I really like this one. I think this one turned out great. But this one I was having a lot struggling. Like this red drawing supply that I used is sort of like a crayon stick. And it was horrible to work with, and I didn't like it at all. If I look at it now, I think it looks fine. It's fine, to be honest, but I just wasn't enjoying it. So we had 15 minutes for this pose, and I just took like 7, and then I went away to make some tea and came back later because I didn't want to work on it anymore. And then I did, I think for this one we also had 15 minutes, so that's why there's a lot more here. And I wanted to try out to make like the ones in the front more detailed and the ones in the back like really simple. And I really like that they all have the little heads. I like that. And I think this one turned out pretty cool. This one was the last one I did, I think. And we only had like 5 minutes, but I think I prepped like the back of the page before we started, so I could work over it while the back was already dry. I think I have one more here, maybe even two. No, it's just one more. Okay. So yeah, this was the last one that we did. So this one was one that we also had 15 minutes for and was somewhere in the middle, I guess. And I tried to start this one with a negative space. So I took this soft pastel and I carved around the shape to do this negative shape thing. And then I went to fill in the doves instead of doing the doves first and doing the background after. This was interesting. I like how it turned out. I really like the muted colors here. And I think it's just a very cute picture. We were drawing for 1.5 hours during this Patreon session, and it was so fun to be able to join Emma Carlisle on this session and the 140 other people that were there. It was the special anniversary thing, so a lot of people were allowed to join even if they were not patrons. So that was really cool, and it was so awesome to be able to be a part of that. So after that Patreon session was done, the couple of days after, I was having like, I still had these doves in my mind because I had a lot of fun drawing them. And of course, since I also drew the chickens, I was like a little bit more comfortable drawing their anatomies now. So I was working on a design for a glass cleaning cloth. And here are some sketches for like the first design that I made, and I'll pop up the picture on the screen of the finished piece. And I think these look so cute. And then here I was trying out to think about maybe making some brush holders that are inspired by like cats and dogs. I haven't done that yet, but I might work on that soon. And I was also planning out like how I want to present my my work on stands when I go to conventions and stuff. So yeah. Here I was feeling a bit unmotivated, and I wasn't really comfortable with my style of how I draw things. So what I did is I went on Pinterest and looked at some pictures. These are dogs that are drawn by Hamotzi on Tumblr, and I just did like some line drawings to kind of copy their style to figure out how they draw things. So these are not my own designs, these are drawn with reference from Hamotzi. They're just to learn, and I didn't do anything with them. Here the same with these cats. And then these birds are ones that I drew myself. So I used reference from Pinterest, probably like picture reference, and I tried to stylize them in like this simple line work style. And I really like how these turned out. I haven't turned them into stickers or something, but I might turn them into another glass cloth pattern. Maybe, I haven't decided yet. Here I was drawing at the cat cafe. And I was just drawing the cats that were like sleeping in front of me, and also some of the cats of the other members of Sketch Tilburg that they were sharing in the Discord. And it was a lot of fun to meet up and look at the cats and draw together. So that was awesome. And I also started working on another glass clots pattern design, which I'll also put up on the screen because that's finished too. I'm not too happy with how this one turned out, but I think I'm happy with how it turned out, but I just like the pigeons one better than this one, but that's okay. I think it's still pretty cute. Here I was sitting outside enjoying some coffee at a cafe and just sketching to work on another glass clot design. I haven't started working on this one yet, but I plan to do this one. And the idea is like foxes that are gardening. So if you see, the first one that I have is like the party pigeons. And then this one, where is it? This one is like the crocheting cats. And for this one, I got the gardening foxes. So I'm just doing like cute animals that are doing human things, which I think is always fun to do. So yeah, I have some really good sketches here. So I do plan on taking some of these and maybe also take like some of the text to put in the design. But yeah, like I said, I haven't started it yet. Here I started doing some like loose pattern design. Yeah, so let me go back to this page a little bit and talk about how I've been doing my sketchbook lately. As you can see, it's not very finished. It's all very loose and a really practical last sketchbook. I really felt like I've been making big steps in developing how I want to do art. And this sketchbook is like really practical. I've been really using it also to practice, but also to get like my ideas on paper where I can work them out somewhere else. And it's been a lot of fun and I feel like I'm learning a lot again. And here I was drawing on location and I was drawing this building and the river that goes under the building. And then a huge group of people started here to like explain about what was going on. And I drew all of the people there that were sitting and listening to these two guys that were talking, which was great. It was great that they wanted to pose for me and stand there. So that's nice. I really like how this one turned out. And then here we are back on the page. I think I haven't done anything after that. Yeah, here we are back on the page that you've seen me do before, where I test out the color palette. So now let me show you what I've done with this color palette. Because of course you saw me draw this in the video. And then I worked on this, but I wasn't really motivated. So this is actually all I've done on that day. I really wanted to get back into ceramics and I didn't really feel like drawing. So there's not a lot. But the day after, I was really feeling down and I wasn't really feeling doing anything at all, but I just made myself sit down outside in the sun and grab some paint and try to do some painting at least. So here I actually wanted to try and fill the whole page with these cats, which I didn't really manage to do. I still made them quite small. So yeah, these are the first two that I made. I think they're fine. Like they're not great or anything, but they're also not that bad. And then I also worked on these, and this one is more stylized. I like that it's more stylized, but it doesn't really feel finished. So maybe I should have done some more. But yeah, I was feeling really down and I didn't really want to do some more, so I guess it's okay. And I think this one looks pretty cool with marks on top. So that's I think it was a, I would call it a successful sketchbook session, even though I didn't do a lot and I can't really use the finished pieces that I have. I've been using my sketchbook more to just keep myself into the creative space and experiment, and I think that's fine too. You don't have to make something special every day. So that's all the drawing I've done in 2 weeks, and I think that was quite a lot for me. Sometimes I draw more, sometimes I draw less, but overall I think it was quite a productive 2 weeks. I hope you guys like this little look into my sketchbook, and if you want me to do more of this kind of stuff, let me know. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, you could support me by subscribing to my channel. That would help my channel a lot and it would allow me to make more videos. It would also help a lot if you just go and watch all my other videos and also leave some comments. That would be great. Alright, see you guys in the next one. Bye!